With a win over the Tigers in Week 15, we get one step closer to winning this division and having a playoff spot with a home game. Now, the problem is the Elks have not called it quits this season. I believe they're about to be 7-7, if I'm not mistaken, and they've beaten us twice this season. So, obviously, if we lose two of the next three games and they win out, they actually steal the division. Now, I will say, if we get to 10 wins, there's a very good chance we make the playoffs anyways, but the difference between a home game and an away game is definitely very massive. Not a great offensive performance against the Tigers this latest week, but the defense, for what seems to be the first time this year, finally stepped up and actually had our back and really carried us to victory as they obviously picked off Stafford 5 times. And now we are on to week 16 against the Sentinels. Do we have a breakout? We don't. I thought maybe we'd done enough, but we didn't. 6-8, their season's not over yet either, even though realistically it's pretty much over. However, if they want to win, you know, a playoff spot, they're definitely going to need to win this week. So we're still in that range of just, you know, enough to get their best. If this was like a week from now and they were like 6-9, you know, maybe you don't get their best. But 6-8, you're still going to get their best, unfortunately. Looking at the weekly awards, you could see that we did get one with Riley Moss, who had a pick 6. Once again, our defense carried. Offense just wasn't good. It just wasn't. But Zach Wilson wins Offensive Player of the Week, which is a little surprising because it's only 3 total touchdowns. Baker Mayfield with 5 total touchdowns, and then Bobby Okereke with a pick and 11 tackles. Definitely nowhere near as good as Riley Moss, in my opinion. But let's take a look at the team. Obviously, this is a team that is getting better and better each week. Really wish Jadarius Lewis would get some more throw power upgrades, though. Gotta be honest. But definitely need to look at some of the season stats as well. See if there's any milestones that can be reached for potential DevOps. The defense, like I said, played really well last week, and Gleason has just been as good as ever. And if you guys want to see another episode of Bisons Franchise tomorrow, 150 likes, and we'll do that thing. Look at Charlie Springs, the GOAT. And that's pretty much the team. Let's take a look at the Sentinels. First things first, take a look at injuries. I know I'm about to jinx it, have been pretty damn lucky this season. Apparently, especially considering other seasons compared to those seasons. Where the hell are the Sentinels? There they are. No injuries for them either. So pretty clean game, it looks to be, at least at kickoff. You know, it could definitely change shortly afterwards. But let's take a look at those Sentinels. Quarterback for the Sentinels is Derek Carr. Definitely not a lot of talent here at this quarterback spot. Maybe got some young players sitting back up, but none of them look really that great. I think Derek Carr is their best quarterback for sure. Travis Etienne, really good running back. Running back 2 is also very fast. Kind of looks like a super poor man's version of Byers because obviously speed's almost there, but doesn't really have the trucking or stiff arm. Looking at wide receiver, Nacua, great wide receiver 1. Jameson Williams starting to develop a little. Release is still a little low. Catching still a little low, but he's still fast as ever. Marquez Smart, very fast slot receiver. So they seem to have their wide receiver 1 through 3 kind of set up. Do need a new tight end, though, as Juwan Johnson's not getting any younger. Still good enough for now, obviously. Jake Matthews is a pretty good left tackle. Reisner's a decent left guard. Mitch Morse is a decent center. City Sow, they need a new right guard for sure. And then right tackle Paris Johnson is really good. Just not that good in the run defense. Then we look at left end, Mata Bike. Very, very good player there, obviously. Right end, Aaron Donald. Very, very good player there. DT, Vita Vea. They have an interior, especially if this is a 3-4, which, I mean, if it's not, someone's got some explaining to. I guess Mata Bike is really athletic, so this is a weird team. It's kind of a weird front, but it's a scary front. I don't see how we're going to run the ball against this team. If this team doesn't have good ranks and run defense, I don't know, like, how. I don't know how it's possible. Christian Harris, though, insanely athletic. Not the best of overalls, but pretty damn good in coverage, obviously. Fred Warner, very, very good middle linebacker. And Blake Cashman's pretty good because of that speed. And then Blake Cashman, speaking of, is going to play that right outside linebacker spot. Corner 1, Christian Gonzalez, really good man press corner. Press man corner. And then Stevenson, ironically enough, the opposite, a very good press zone corner. So not really sure what they're going on with that. Instead of, you know, just being good at one style, they're like, best of both worlds. It's like, yeah, but if you run a slant against Stevenson, he's kind of dead, right? Malik Hooker, though, you know, decent. And then Cameron Curl, not the fastest, but pretty damn good, especially with kind of the run defense stuff. Kicker, really strong. Punter, decently strong. But looking at what we're going to do against this team, I think defending the short pass makes a lot of sense right out the gate. Let's see what they're actually good at. They just suck. Okay. We're going to defend the short pass, and then I think we're going to have to throw the ball, right? Yeah, number four rush defense in the league. I think medium attack for throwing. And then I think these are the guys you want to focus on. See, it's not about getting XP necessarily for me, but it's also the dev. I think Cordarrelle Jackson he's overstayed his welcome at that position, to be honest. These are the guys you're going to try to develop. It's a lot of normal dev guys, like I said, because I want to get their devs up. But Joe Morant and the quarterback, they kind of, you know, they're the outliers because they're basically the faces of the offense, besides Rodriguez, who's already a 90 overall anyways. After all of that weekly strategy, somehow only one player has an upgrade point, and it's Nick Jones. I mean, he's really good in the slot, and I like the man coverage in the slot, so we're going to go with a slot upgrade, which gives him a speed, which is worth it automatically. Could literally have just been a plus one to speed, and it's worth it every time. Speed is just so important. Here we go. Looks like it's trying to rain, but it's not going to. It's kind of the opposite of real life for me. It is thunderstorming all day today, so basically the best day of all time. Joe Moran, 1,164 yards, 9 touchdowns. Kind of forgot to look at the team season stats so far, but if Morant's around 1,100, I'd imagine like Romeo Doubs and Wise might be each at about 800. Kuntz, I feel like he's had a down year, but he did have a couple of really good games sprinkled in, so he could also be around 800. Rodriguez, obviously over 1,000, and sack totals, we already know. Gleason's double digits, and Jackson's nowhere near double digits. But yeah, as far as what we control, definitely need to get the ball more to Romeo Doubs. Wise wouldn't be terrible either. Be nice to get, you know, just a full offense of star plus devved players, which of course would need those two wide receivers to get going a little bit more. Obviously, they play their part. They usually have like a really big play during the game, so it's not like they're not doing their job. It's just statistically, the ball usually goes to Rodriguez and Morant, so we'll see what happens. Obviously, winning the game is the most important thing, but also thinking about the future, trying to get DevOps. But either way, we're going to be kicking the ball off first, speaking of the future, as we'll be getting the ball in the future at the second half starting points. Both teams need the win, but Sentinels definitely need it more. Their season is, I would imagine, over if they lose this game, as their fast slot receiver is the kick return man. Not going to have a chance there. That ball is booted deep. Derek Carr, he's damn near ready to retire himself, and with a season like this, it could be his final year in general. 17 touchdowns, 16 interceptions, 3,000 yards. Yeah, he's probably about to retire. And we're going to want to make him retire early on, as we're going to be bringing a blitz the very first play. Let's see if we can get in there. And we just completely sold. ETN slipping off the tackles, try to get vertical. And that's already a gain of 27 on the first play. I don't know how we missed that tackle, though. We got to bring him down. Bad look from us. I wouldn't say quick hike, but wasn't really ready. Hesitated last second. I was like, oh, actually, I want to move this player, and didn't get a chance to cover for him. And we're going to cut it all the way back with Johnson, who is going to miss the tackle because he did not expect his teammate to get trucked. That is pretty absurd. ETN, great week last week. Overall, I didn't actually get to see those numbers. They went away so quickly. We're running the blitz, too. Yeah, I thought they were going to throw the ball short. They're just running the ball, and there's a read option. We're trying to get out there with Johnson, try to strip it. Almost got it, but Ryan Moss kind of stole the tackle there. 7 yards gain for Derek Carr. For him at this age and the way he's played this season, to be risking it all like this for a team that probably doesn't make the playoffs is definitely impressive. Good hit, but holds on. Mr. Nacua to the 20. Okay, this time we're going to have it covered. Unless it's a play action, we're going to get beat for the touchdown. This time they're not going to gain anything on the run. Okay, they didn't run it. I said they weren't going to gain anything. Back of the end zone. He's going to throw it away. Don't you dare. They would have called a freaking penalty on that. I would have been so mad. We actually finally stopped them to something that wasn't damn near a first down. And, oh, there goes Gleason off the edge. Free rush. Sacked. 3rd and 18 from the 27-yard line. Gleason is unbelievable. You put that number 98 on any edge rusher, they become a god. Jack Gleason. Didn't even get to see it. It was so quick. Jackson's at least pushing in there, but yeah, Gleason's already got him down by the time he's even off of his man. Gleason's just too fast with it. Too quick. Is that ETN going against Cam Jones, or should I say the other way around? And that's a perfect throw to Nacua. And he's going to fight his way into the end zone. I mean, wow. Broke off like multiple tackles there. We did a good job of taking on the inside route, and unfortunately there was a second inside route that was a little bit deeper, and that's the one he took. Figure that super inside leverage needed more help, and that's where he went, and yep, Nacua burned us. Touchdown. That sucks, because after that sack, it felt like it was absolutely going to be, you know, a field goal stop, but instead they're going to score 7. Yeah, we're trying to cut it back inside. Gets slammed to the ground. There goes Jadarius Lewis coming out on the field. Obviously, the touchdown to pick ratio is still positive, but it's not really separating as much as we thought it was going to. Better than Derek Carr's numbers, but that's not really saying much at this point. But yeah, I mean, there was really nothing we could have done. Ooh. Depending on how they play this, touchdown? Oh my God, how does Fred get up there? How is Fred getting a hand on that? I thought, you know, maybe I took too long to throw it. The fact that I took that long and he still got a hand on it is crazy. Could be a quick throw to Kuntz, speaking of. Going to be a sack right out the gate almost. But yeah, so, you know, talking about that touchdown play, if we cover Nacua, that inside got so open, it's unbelievable. That was just going to easily be a first down no matter what. That's a dot. Oh my, what a catch. Unbelievable coverage by that cornerback. He almost made a play on it, but we clutched up. Continue the drive. Beautiful. Oh, I'm going to go with the play action, but we got to switch sides. They're coming up on what it looks to be a blitz. Morant, perfect throw again. There you go. Try to cut inside. Couldn't quite do it to the 27-yard line. Big play. 54 yards now down the field. Pre-snap looked great, and unfortunately, we're going to have to freaking throw the ball again. They are playing that run to the outside. Romeo Doubs getting involved, like we said. And, oh, up the field for 12. Don't know who that was, but they should have easily had him. That's why, yeah, you don't want to get hit in the NFL, but at the same time, you just never know how a defender is going to play it, so you got to play till the whistle. And we're in some trouble. We actually got a little bit of time there. Unfortunate throwaway. Morant won off the line, but the problem is you're not going to be able to do anything with it because the way the route was lined up, he was just going to run right back into it. Can I ID the mic? Thank you. Please, let me do one more thing. I promise I won't do any more. Whew, I thought we were going to get a false start. Double team in Vita Vea. And what a block by the left guard as Morant didn't see it. Tyreek Stevenson holding his knee in his shoulder. I think he just died. I think he's dead. Of course, 3rd and 2 without him on the field now. Could be a little bit easier. We'll see. See how they want to play this. Oh, that's pretty good coverage. Back of the end zone. Oh, my. Almost picked off. 4th and 2. How do you want to play this? I don't know. Sound like I just had a conversation with myself. Inside handoff. Rodriguez to the left. Vita Vea is on the wrong side here. If we can get to the line in time. Easily. Touchdown, Rodriguez. Worthy conversion attempt. I don't know what they did at the D-line spot there, but they should have Vita Vea on that side. All tied up after the conversion. Beautiful. And we get double team, kind of chipped. Makes sense. Gleason's absolutely a problem. And not going to go man coverage as Puka Nacua is got Cam Jones manned up on him. To the outside on the RPO. Good tackle, but a first down anyways. Starting to sprinkle in that pass quite a bit. Going to make this run game even tougher to stop. Oh, he cuts right to the side we were. Good teamwork. Gains 3. Thought it would have been more, so that's fine. About to say, you cannot have James manned up with their speedy guy. I mean, even then, Riley Moss is kind of outmatched here. And like we said, good strip attempt. First down. What can I say? When you beat, you beat. From the 49, not going to get there. And what a try, but he gets knocked down. I mean, good tackle, I guess, but Etienne trucked right over James. Gains 8. Really tripped over his legs, if we're going to be honest. But I guess a tackle's a tackle. Aw, free play. And of course, we stop him, too. The fake hike tricked him. Is that Gleason? It was Walt James. Oof, not a good couple of refs. Reps. The ref's like, huh? What? You trying to call us corrupt? It's like, well, I mean, kind of, yeah. But not this time. This time, you're fine. Manned up against Puka. Free rush. Oh, how does he hold on to that? Looked like the middle linebacker had a free rush in there, but couldn't get there in time. From the 31-yard line. Motion. And there we go. We read the play. I think it's just you have to read it, all right? There's a chance that it's either going to the running back, the wide receiver, or the QB keeps it. If we go straight at the QB and running back, you know, it's 66% chance we get the guy that has the ball. And that's really the odds I took. You know, the wide receiver gets it, fair enough. You won the route. You won the rep. Good job. And sacked by Quincy. Might be out of field goal range. It's a long field goal. It's definitely doable, but don't know what the wind is like. Quincy getting in there, and that will be a punt. Good stuff. Can we block this thing? Straight rush. Okay, I guess we can't move. And that ball is like side. Oh, it's actually a pretty good. Never mind. I actually thought that was within like the 15. But no, it's not. 15 yards away from being a good punt. Inside, Wise. Perfect throw. Gets under it cleanly. I mean, there was some traffic in there. Good stuff. Offensive line was kind of losing its ground a little bit. Bellinger. Oh, I like Morant being out there. See how they want to play that. And Bellinger's open this time. Not going to hit it. The pressure was absolutely on. Blake Cashman waving his finger like he actually did something there. Unless that was him blitzing. And there goes Rodriguez, who almost breaks the ankles of Curl. Gains 7. I know it hasn't been like necessarily like a cakewalk, but surprised we're doing as well as we are against a defense is good. And honestly, let's go to the second quarter. 7-7. Defense is doing its part for the most part, and the offense is moving on the field. We're a little inefficient, but we have had some big plays. I think if you're able to break off a few big plays early in the game, even if you're inconsistent, it tells me that there's a good chance that you're going to have an okay day. We want it all. We don't even, you know, honestly, I don't even know if I would say I wanted it all. I just didn't believe that Bellinger was going to get the first down. They're saying to go for it. I don't know if I agree with this. Slants. They've been in pretty good coverage, though, to be fair. Got Beatty on the field. 5 receivers. And we're in trouble. Damn, this offensive line is losing. And I get it, because they should. This D-line is insane. And looking back at that play, they covered everything. It's just perfectly covered. Their defense is good. Oh, we overran it. That's all right, because it just caught him off guard. He was like, oh, that guy's already in. Good job finishing up, though. That's disgusting. All right, let's see it. 2nd and 10. Can't get off the line. And Cam Jones is, look at the tackle by Cordell. But Cam Jones is on fire. Stop that play dead in its tracks. And then Cordell, good job off the backside, getting kind of like free rush. Let's see if Jackson can get the push. Got to go against 2 players. Oh, could it be picked? What a diving interception. Almost like an arm punt anyways. But to the 27, I mean, even though their punting is pretty bad, you would assume that's better field position. What a dive. The 6'3 Johnson. That's a big Johnson. Antonio Johnson. Interception. I mean, he was in good enough coverage, even if the throw was clean. Gleason all over that. Just a terrible throw, but, I mean, why not, I suppose. Where you could consider that a bad play because we got decent field position. Could have been, you know, a blocked punt. You never know. And there you go. Ah, not a good enough block. That's all right, though, as Morant takes it to the 48. Already almost up to 100 yards on the day. Definitely over 1,000 on the season, without a doubt. I just don't like the run looks. I mean, that front four on their own is scary. But when you put those linebackers in there as well, like, what are we doing, you know? Oh, my God, what are we doing? Terrible blocking. Christian Harris makes a crazy play there. We gain a yard. A yard on a screen for us is, like, basically negative 10 on a run. Like, we are way too good of a screen team to be giving up, you know, those kind of block looks. That's a late throw, but more importantly, a bad one. All right, back to this kind of lineup. Kuntz, it's a tough one. That's a great throw. Just straight up dropped. Field goal is going to be a bit tough. I think this is a punt. Both teams went down. First drive, scoring a touchdown, and then a bunch of nothing after that. This punt does not look great either. Oh! It's close, but it's going to be inside, unfortunately. Damn. Always going for the sideliner. Sometimes maybe just put a little backspin on it. Keep it in bounds. That's the type of punting we don't really do a whole lot of, though. Try to limit the return as much as possible. And good teamwork. Still giving up 7, but Gleason doing his job. I'm going to let Gleason do his thing. He doesn't really need the help. Oh, good bull rush. Oh, all up in his face. And it's all for nothing as they gain another 7 first down. From the 34-yard line, going to go with Ronnie again. That bull rush was actually pretty nice. Doesn't happen this time. Oh, it does, but it's wide open down the sideline. Smart with the speed. Burning Riley Moss, the rookie. He is fast. Want to see if they want to show us the line play. No. I mean, he doesn't jam him, but he gets an okay press. He just gets burned. All right, we're going to run the stretch. Let's go left. And maybe should have went in. Oh, and he fumbles. What a recovery by Bellinger. I mean, he's just one of those guys. Like, he's just one of those dudes that does the thing, you know? I think that was very eloquently said. I mean, they're in really good coverage. That's a tough catch for Rodriguez. A little out there in general, but the coverage is amazing. We haven't run the ball, like I said, because it's just not really many, like, spots to go. We gained 4 yards on the run that should have gained a yard, but we fumbled forward. And we're going to have to outrun him, which we're not going to get. Didn't have the range, in my opinion, to cut back for the blocks, which last time we cut back for the block didn't work anyways. It's going to be another punt, which is almost blocked. They're going to say we got ran into. Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. That's our ball. Absolutely accepting that. I don't know why we handled the ball so terribly, but at least it turned out to be a good thing. Kuntz wide open. Holds on. Oh, he's got room. Kuntz around the sideline. Stiff arm down to the 19. Great block. There you go. I mean, that play did not look like it was going to gain that much, and it did. Let's go with the reverse tight end. And there's just nobody open. Might have been a couple of looks in there if we threw like a perfect pass at the tight end, but yeah, throw away. Whole lot of nothing. You know, we got a couple of big plays, but a whole lot of nothing other than those big plays. Vita Vea, I believe, does have inside stuff, so you pretty much always have to double team him, despite the fact that Aaron Donald's like right there. Which, speaking of, oh, nice blocks. Got the first down to the 9. Maybe should have ran straight on. I didn't really think about where the lineup was. Could have got that ball inside like the 7, maybe. Let's run it again. This time double team Vita Vea again, I suppose. Wait, are we not running the ball? Do they have like a thing that makes things bad? Maybe not. Ah, oh, there goes Aaron Donald. Damn it. Loss of 2. 9-11. We backed out of the sweep last time. This time, I mean, we kind of need something to kind of just go well. Oh, what a play by number 6. Gonzalez spun out of the block. And it would have been a touchdown if he didn't. Damn, that play actually worked. We usually never see that work. That's going to be picked off. Oh, my God. Cameron Curl just misread the jump. Terrible ball, but in general, I think it was Fred Warner picked up the play amazingly well. It's going to be a field goal. Was that Fred Warner? I mean, he's amazing, so obviously give him some credit. No, it was Christian Harris. Look at this. I expect him to stay mid, and I was like, oh, no, and I didn't see the guy in behind, Romeo Doubs. And, I mean, he just misreads it, thankfully. 3 minutes in the second, and they have potential to extend the lead. Ronnie. Oh, couldn't get the swat. Tried to go for the pick afterwards. 4 yards gain. Perfect throw. Not bad at coverage. Derek Carr from under center. I mean, kind of have to leave the running back there. Either leave the dump off to the running back or you leave the receiver running down the field. Especially since it's not even our job. Ours is that outside. We had a middle linebacker that was supposed to be underneath middle. Get up, Cam. Oh, what is Riley Moss doing, honestly? Try to strip it because we have help. Good hit by Riley in the end, but I don't know where Riley Moss is going. He's like over-pursuing an angle that he hasn't even taken yet. Come on, man. This defense is struggling. And Antonio Johnson almost just had himself another gift wrap. Thing that sucks about getting burned so much by your guy. Oh, Lord. Speaking of getting burned by your guy, we're not really ready. Cover 2 because of the underneaths. 1-on-1. Taylor gets his ankles broken. Etienne brings it to the 24. 3rd and 1. I mean, you got to go for the blitz here. You get off the field here. This is massive. Not only do you force the field goal, but you also get yourself a chance before half as well. And nice hit by Wilson to likely force the field goal. What a pop. See if Forbes can block it even. You never know. Not going to happen, but hey, it's a stop for once. 1:24 in the second. Let's see if Ivana Kana can spark something. Looks like better lined up blocks. I think we cut it to the one side that looked good, to the 31. It's not bad. Got this kind of like weird little route by the running back again. About to take the tight end, but Blitz got in there. Not even blitz. I think it was just another good rush. A lot of one-on-ones, it seems like. It's a tough throw, and it's almost picked off. Bad throw. Deflected? I think maybe right at the end they called it a deflection because it hit his foot. Quick look into Morant, perhaps. And, of course, good job at alignment to pick that up. Popped hard, fumbles. Another punt. Their defense has been on another level this game. There goes Forbes. Good job on the run downfield. I thought he did not. When did he fair catch it, though? ETN, 1,000 yards on the season. 11 touchdowns. Don't know what the receiving numbers are like, but they got to be another couple hundred. Have himself a good year. This has been a long first half, though. I'll tell you that much. Move him over to the left. Curl route. Wide open. Who would have thought? Don't know why he's just running to the end zone. Oh, I got a deep blue defense. I guess I'll just run to the end zone. It's like, no, judge it by how the receiver's running. If he's not running full blast, you know he's not going to streak. Maybe it's a double move or something, but just, you don't have to bite. Just stay in range so you don't get beat. Oh, what a hit. That was one of those, like, season-ending type hits. Laid him up perfectly. Hit him right in, like, the knee area. What a pop. Left that out. Please! Riley Moss, that's pick sixth. Back-to-back weeks. Derek Carr took too long. The ball took a while to, you know, just get there in general. And we're going to tie this game up before our half, despite having a bad offense. That ball took so long to get out there. And us not covering our guy paid off as we have now tied the game up. Riley Moss late, but it works out to perfection. Baited that thing. For some reason, they want to go for some shot here. No timeouts or anything. They're just going to go for a Hail Mary, maybe. We're not going to get off the block. Come on, Gleason. It's free. It's a free sack, man. Taylor? I don't know how they don't call that PI. Went for the pick, and Taylor, for some reason, right before the ball got there, decided to blast them. Unless it was a bang-bang play, and our guy deflected it or something. I didn't see it, but it felt like we just tackled him. I actually just feel like we just tackled him there. I would love to see that back, but we're not going to. Halftime, 17 all. We get ball at half, and the yards reflect they do have like 70 more than us, but it makes sense. Once again, they got an extra possession we didn't. The Monarchs absolutely crushing the Dreadnoughts, who look like they are not going to be making the playoffs. Dreadnought, 24-point deficit. Holy crap. On a different stratosphere, as the Dragons are winning 17-0 against the Shamrocks. Trying to go to 8-7, give themselves a chance at the playoffs. And then you look at the Mounties versus the Thunderbirds. The Mounties at 12-2 on the season. You know, kind of getting upset almost, 7-10 here. The odds would tell you you'd be winning if you took the under, obviously. And there you go. No Elks, though. We're not seeing the Elks. Looking down the field, though, big play to Smart. I mean, even slowed up on the play and still burned Riley. But Riley, obviously, definitely made up for it. It's a lot easier to get beat for a touchdown than it is to score one on defense. And we're going to stop the run. Bonaconda had himself a decent little return before half. Didn't really mean anything. Slips off a tackle there. Gets to the 22. Nothing going on that return. We threw the run game to the back burners because they just really weren't allowing us to run, but I mean, at some point, you gotta say, hey, we can block better than you can block shed. And actually worked out there, 9 yards. Good blocking. As long as you double-team, I guess we're going to go left, even though we have the tight end on the other side. Double-team Vita Vea on those inside runs, you should be fine. And Vita Vea just killed us anyways, even though it wasn't even an inside. We need 1 yard. I'm betting on it that we can get it. And this is why I never bet. Oh, what a push from behind. 4th and 1. You got to go for this. Surely they can't stop us for those yards again. I just don't understand how they're doing this. Like, what's going on here? Beatty, the little hero he is, first down. Like, the coverage in this game has just been absurd. I just don't get it. Running up the middle. Aaron Donald getting sealed off. We gained about 7. His front is no joke. Aaron Donald on the outside now instead of the inside. And there goes more room. Rodriguez showing off some speed to the 41. Nice run. Starting to pick it up a little bit. And I got to say, I don't like the front this time. They got a lot of players there. That's pretty good coverage. And Morant drops it. Get this guy on him, but it seems like Hooker had his hands up late. I really didn't even feel like he defended that. I think that was just a drop. I don't even know. But now we're behind. And, I mean, just instantly sacked. 9 for 25, and it's literally, like, almost all the offensive line. As long as you don't throw a pick, though, we are in field goal range. So you got to keep that in mind when, you know, evaluating the risk. Oh, tight end wide open. Great throw. I mean, not great, but good enough. Huge hit to the 21. Big play. Ironically enough, Cameron Curl is the guy that got beat. That would be a direct, like, insult. It wasn't even intended, obviously, but that's crazy. Doing some curls. Stretch to the outside. I mean, I don't even know who you double-team here because you have a pretty good edge rusher over there, too. And Rodriguez will show off enough speed. Cuts inside, breaks the ankles of Curl this time to the 9. Pretty hard spot to score from. We got that fake sweep. I do not believe in that. Bellinger. Bellinger holds on down to the 2. Beautiful throw and catch. You got that wildcat look. Romeo Doubs. And the blocks are decent. Nice cut. Slammed into the end zone by Aaron Donald. Romeo Doubs is in. The blocks were, you know, it was kind of iffy. The interior blocked well, but the edge, what a cutback. Beautiful play. We now have the lead. Little trick play action as we've been struggling from the goal line. Been struggling in general, to be fair. Running back, there's nobody on him. Misses the tackle, even though he went low. That's how you go low. 9 yards gained anyways, though. Make it look like we're going mid. Riley Moss trying to get over there. Good hit by Cam Jones. First down. And even though it looks so predictable to do it, we're going to be running the blitz this time instead of actually faking it out. And there goes the rush. Ronnie Shelton gets the sack, and that'll be a 2nd and 18. He's getting ready to swat that ball. So I thought he was going to throw it. Getting burned out there is Johnson. Good tackle by Taylor. It's 10 yards after the 8-yard sack. Let's get Johnson blitzing in there. Move him over. Get up there. Good tackle. Going to be 2 yards short. What do you do here? They're going to say punt. I don't know if I would say I agree with as that ball ends up going into the end zone for a touchback. Let's actually run inside here. Oh, Aaron Donald. No. Anyone but Aaron Donald or Vita Vea on this D-line. And, of course, they have both of them. Anyone but those two, and we're looking good. Of course not, though. Screen pass really hasn't worked today. Aaron Donald's on it, but he does get blocked. Tries to break the ankles, can't, gains 4. Inside cross. Morant on that drag from the slot. Running back, please catch it. Thank you. Rodriguez drops those so often. Huge burn play. Almost back to 50% completion percentage. Who would have thought? Keep on completing on. We're just going to go verticals. I like the tight end here. I don't like him that much. That is a risky one. And of course, he just picks it off. That was such a stupid throw. Huge hit, but I don't know why I threw that. Like, don't get me wrong, the vision's there, obviously, right? The wide receiver is winning his route, but you know how crazy of a throw that needed to be? It's a really good throw, considering with the guys all over him again. But Wise couldn't even get back to the ball in time. A little bit of PI, though, if you really... I mean, like, when did Hooker get his hands on the ball? Because... I don't know. It kind of feels like Wise got smothered before the ball was even touched. Either way, that was an ill-advised throw. Ooh, bad throw, speaking of. 3rd and 8 now. A defense of theirs, though, it just makes it so hard. Oh, I'm not ready for this. Yeah. Not ready for that wide open over the middle. It's ironic enough because I was trying to move him to the middle and then switch to the purple on the outside. Instead, it basically move the guy out of position for the easy touchdown to Nacua. Abanaconda on the return. Oh, come on. Somebody get a block. We would have had a touchdown. Either way, to the 4th quarter. It's a close one. We have the ball, though. Let's see if we can actually get down the field. Like, realistically, I want to go with the quick play because nothing else has worked, but even that hasn't worked. Oh, there's no way they cover this. Cancel the play action, and Morant should be free. Maybe not. What a throw. Damn, what a throw to the 50. Kind of touch past it over the middle in between them. And, you know, you want to run the ball here. And sure, maybe you can get that off to the left, but why when I could just play action and probably get a bigger play? And he misses him. See, it's one of those games where it would be nice to have that quicker quarterback, because at least you get a guy that can run and create something. Great throw. Nobody on him. Good hit. Gains 8. But Jadarius Lewis doesn't really have that speed to create. Kind of wish he would have just faked an injury or something. Could have caught and gotten someone else in. 3rd and 2 with the fullback lead. Let's see. And he's not going to get it. That might be a field goal. I can't believe the speed of this team, though. 58-yarder for Chad Ryland. A little bit of wind. I think we've adjusted for it as long. Oh, no. I think we should be fine. There we go. A little short, but that's fine. We have the lead again. All right, from the 45-yard line with a pretty decent return and a quick throw for the first down. Got ourselves blitzing and good teamwork, specifically Walt James getting in there. That's a loss of 1. That's what it sounds like when I'm on the toilet. 2nd and 11 from the 43. A little press, had to get rid of him. Overran. Aww. Curse you, bad change of direction. I felt like he played that amazingly well. Slowed down the tight end with the press on the outside and then ran to the middle and just couldn't turn around in time. No, Ronnie. Good job. Two big DTs made a play there. Look at these guys. Now we're going to go with the mid, but you do need to get that press. We'll stay back just in case Nakua wins. And he won't. To the outside. Good teamwork. Good job. Gains nothing. Takeaways ranked 10. Got 2 today. I mean, kind of tricks. I mean, we kind of got here by blitzing. I don't see why we wouldn't blitz again. Let's get in here. Great coverage. They're going to call it. There's no way they call a flag on that. That is such a bad flag. It's unbelievable. Like, watch this back. Like, sure, he gets contacted, but he doesn't get impeded. Like, where? They're running together. This is a flag. They're going to call that a flag. Where? You've got to be kidding me. That is an insanely bad call. Got way too many DBs on the field. And we caught him. Wow, we just saved a touchdown. And we were supposed to be blitzing on the other side. If we're not there, that's a touchdown. I now realize why we get torched so much when we blitz. Because if I'm not actually making the play there, I mean, that's literally a score. The outside, that ball's terrible. Good coverage anyways. 3rd and 7 for the 33. Of course, it would have probably been a punt. But at least if we get off the field here, you know, the flag doesn't mean as much. But as of right now, that flag absolutely is carrying them to some points here. Get off the line, and then some. Good tackle down to the 5. Normally, I just blow that play completely and let him run by me, so improvement, I suppose. And sacked by Weatherford. He's about to just take a shot to the corner, really, against the ball hawk. Looking pretty decent on the pass rush. 1-on-1. Good hit to the 11. 3rd and goal. Applying a little bit of pressure, but also keeping it safe enough. Could just be a waste the clock, get the tying field goal type of play. We'll see, though. Not going to be. And why is there anyone not on him? Touchdown, Sentinels. I really don't know how someone could be that open. Why are we not defending him? Like, I don't think it was, like, a sharp comeback or curl route. I think he just left him. Like, where is my man's going? This guy did a pretty decent job stepping up. Curl route. He's watching the play. He stops. He takes another step back? Where are you going? Jeez, man. I just don't understand. Like, what's the thought process? You're watching the play, and you see him stop, and you continue going? Nabanaconda is just barely going to get to the 25. It's a hell of an attempt, but nothing really spectacular, unfortunately. Touchdown, regains the lead by 3. Double-teaming Vita Vea on that stretch to the right. I believed in the blocks. I mean, it works out. And a face mask. That's all right. That's a big play. The flags are coming out in droves? Troves? I don't damn know. A lot of flags. Long story short, a lot of flags. Play action. Usually we don't get the time to throw that out there, but we'll see. That play action is pretty busted. That throw is a bit out there, but great catch. Stiff arm and all to the 27. Maybe getting down the field a little bit too quickly now. But at the same time, they want to put all these really good players on the interior. Pretty much have no choice but to just throw. Try to get that out quickly. Give Coots a chance to catch it and then move downfield. It's 5 yards. See, this time I think we can get the play. I think we can double team and just play inside. And that does work. Nice ankle breaker down to the 12. Beautiful play. Got to get the touchdown, though, unfortunately. There's no field goal safety blanket. And we set it up nicely. Good juke move inside and down to the 5. Gains 8. Beautiful play. 2-minute warning. You would think they would learn. Those DBs out there, like, if they're playing way out, we're cutting in. If they're playing direct line, we're cutting out. But nope, every time they fall for it. And I think with 2nd and 2, you got to try this again, especially on that left side. Good blocking, Williams. Tries to spin back inside to the 2. Clock will be running. You would imagine they let the clock go once, and then they play it by ear and see what happens here. No, I do not want to double team number 53. Just enough time. A lot of clock wasted. Boom. And that will likely be a touchdown. Barely. The lineman just didn't want to engage with anyone. We'll get the touchdown, though. See, that was a nice drive. Like, that was actually pretty good from the 25-yard line. 1:12 in the fourth. Wide open on the outside again. Great tackle. We actually got... Oh, nice hit last second. Thankfully, it wasn't a flag. Oh, no. I guess we're just going to run the same coverage we just ran. And that's all right. Nice hit. That's okay, but they're already in field goal range. This could be overtime. The long singular game episodes every damn time. I mean, outside, they're just cooking us alive. And we let them out of bounds. Way to go. Forget overtime. They're going to win. Come with that blitz on the same side. They keep looking. Oh, no. Keep them in bounds, at least, I suppose. No matter what we run, we're getting absolutely destroyed right now. Quick look outside. Get over there. Good strip attempt. Clock should definitely progress quite a bit now, though. Play them off. Play man coverage because we get burned in zone all game long. And, okay, fair enough. I don't think they're going to have a chance. It's going to be a field goal. But getting down to the 5 here, they should have definitely just taken a shot into the end zone. I don't like that. We'll ice them because we can't take these timeouts with us, but unfortunately, we played that about as poorly as possible. They damn near scored the touchdown. Try to get the block, though. Oh! I guess I wouldn't really care too much if we got the penalty anyways. I can't believe we didn't block that. The fact that that wasn't blocked and when it was slivers away is so painful. And you might as well return the damn thing. Best chance at the big play anyways. Just nowhere to go. That's going to be overtime. It's been a little while, in fairness. Yardage-wise, they do have us beat, but score-wise, it is obviously all tied up as we're headed on to overtime. I'm going to say heads. I was going to say tails, and thankfully I did not. This has been an unbelievably long... What the hell kind of sinking trick is that? Dude, this has been a long, unbelievable one. 34 all, and we need an extra game, an extra quarter in this game. And, okay, return to the 26. Oh, positive yardage. Obviously, we're looking at a brand new game here, pretty much. So, running the ball back on the table. And, I mean, Vita Vea is just so big, we couldn't even get through the block. The wham was too large. What is the considered pass? Okay, so that's fine. We can play one more, like, throw without throwing to the tight end if we don't want to. We can't get the ball off to Wise. The blocking. It's been a disaster this game, but the screen pass is and will always forever be our bailout play. So when we need a bailout, I'm going to go to it. And Aaron Donald says, nope. This Sentinels defense has been unbelievable. I genuinely don't know how we even came this close, and I don't know how. I get their offense is kind of bad. I have no idea how they aren't better than they are. And that ball is a very good punt. Problem is, we've sucked on defense. And as much as we suck on the first drive, like every time in overtime, you can't punt the ball first. You'd look so stupid. But then again, we look stupid anyways. Good hit. That should have been a fumble. How is he not fumbling there? We've gotten to stop this game, so let's maybe have a second one of those. That'd be great. And we did a really good job to save that. That would have been a free run. Run of the press. I don't know who needs the help more. Get over there. Yes. Maybe could have had a pick. I don't care. That was a long reach out play And I just wanted to get a hand on that ball. Yeah, I mean, I don't think we're wrong for not going for the pick there. Like, that's crazy. We actually made a stop after getting stopped in overtime. That's crazy. I'm sure the NFL, tiebreaker decider guys are like, yeah, I would love to see what a tie looks like for the tiebreaker in the division. 20 yards puts us in field goal range. Trying to look for a little bit of a shorter look, potentially. There goes Romeo Doubs, who does not hold on. Not exactly sure what you want me to do about that, but sure. I guess. Play action. I like the tight ends a lot. And Bellinger falling forward gains two. I mean, Aaron Donald was in our face immediately. Had to throw that right away. And I know we only gained 2 yards on that play, but that play right there is the exact reason why we invested in backup tight end. Romeo. Perfect throw. Finally, we clutch up somewhere. First down at the 42-yard line. Another curl up. Was it Cameron Curl again? Is that why? Oh, my God. Another free rush. Can we just get a little bit of time to throw? Like, that's all I ask. Just a tiny bit. Come on, fullback. Damn it, fullback. I knew it was going to be him that needed to make the play. I knew it. I really don't want to run this ball because we have not moved the ball at all on the ground. And, you know, we're setting this game up to be a field goal. We're going to do it anyways. I mean, that's a decent little run to the 38-yard line. I mean, it's field goal time, I suppose. 55 yards, that's it's not the hardest for Chad Ryland, but it is for me. I think that's in. I mean, I think it looks good. Chad Ryland's going to win us another one this year. Unbelievable game. I mean, their defense was unbelievable. Our offensive line was smoked so many times. And of course, they're pointed at Jadarius, who really... I mean, the yards are fine. The touchdown-to-pick ratio type of situation kind of... It does resemble a team that struggled. But at the same time, we did have a couple of rushing touchdowns, and then three of them to be exact. So, you know, you put three touchdowns on one pick against a D-line that was that good, it's not that bad. It's really not. Putting up 298 yards is really tough against a defense like that. Rodriguez, it was a hard-fought 103. Receiving, Nacua was great for them. Kuntz had some plays. Morant obviously had most of his plays in the first quarter. It was just a team effort, really. Defense had its plays. Obviously, the pick six from Riley Moss was absolutely clutch, completely needed. And we barely hold on for the victory. 10-5 now. One more win, and we win the division. Cordell Jackson with an upgrade point. Going block stopper, run stopper this time, because at this point, if his 91 power move isn't good enough to get him into the backfield, then maybe it's just block shed. I know someone said that before, but the problem with that theory is the fact that Gleason has, I think, even worse block shedding than Cordell. And he obviously has, well, at the time, a lot worse finesse. His finesse is definitely up there now a little bit because all those sacks are going to get you some XP. But, you know, 69 block shed for him with only 83 finesse now. So, yeah, I don't know. I just, some people have it, some people don't, I guess. I will hope that Gleason goes at least star, maybe superstar, though, in the offseason. But regardless, that's a win. The Sentinels gave us another a tough one, as did the Tigers. Our offense has been a little inconsistent lately, but regardless of the point, we are still obviously in control of our own destiny. And if the Elks even lose, the division is ours. But it's looking pretty good. We got the Antlers next week, very similar to the Elks, and then the Black Knights in Week 18. Both home games could see some snowy ones. I freaking hope so, at least. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this one, maybe leave a like. Subscribe if you're new. If you're not new, I do appreciate continued support on the channel. Maybe follow me on Twitter, Jeromepkr. Second channel, Pkr Plays, for non-Madden content. And that is basically it. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys come back for next video. But until next video...